So this time I'd like to consider the use of more than one PIR. So in this case, we've got three PIRs working together. We've got a 6 amp circuit breaker, and again, we have our lights. Now this, where have I used this before? I've done circuits like this before in, say, on the outside, for outside lighting, where I might have PIRs at the front and the side and the rear of the house, and they all operate the various lights that are situated at the outside lights around the house. So if someone was to walk at the front of the house, this PIR would turn the lights on, which are all the way around the house, and also at the rear of the house or the side of the house. So all three PIRs operate the lights. So again, it's important that that the lights are connected to neutral or have a neutral connection to them. And again, a neutral connection will also go to the first PIR, and then they simply just link across. Now, in a domestic installation, this could just be the use of, say, 3-core and earth. And then we shall, again, it's quite simple. We just take the first to the first PIR. We take the live supply to the first PIR. And again, this is just simply connected across, just like so. And again, this one here, these now just interconnect as well. So it's really quite simple. Now, at any point, all of these are now connected together in parallel. And so all we need to do is, from one of these points somewhere, anywhere along this line here, we just need to take a connection. I'm just going to take the connection from here. And so we take the connection to the lights, and again, all three PIRs are now controlling those lights. Again, it's a good idea to have the time switch, the times all set to about the same sort of time, but although it doesn't really matter. This one could be set at a different time, and so if this one was set on, say, 10 seconds and this one went off, it would only last for 10 seconds. Whereas if this one was to go and that was operated for 2 minutes, then again, this one would operate the lights for 2 minutes until that one, the timer runs out on that one. So again, that's relatively simple. So again, looking at the circuit using three PIRs, this can also have a one-way switch to be used, and that will act as an override switch. And so again, I'm just going to take it from anywhere along the circuit. I'm going to take a connection from this one here, and connect it across. And then from this one here, I'm going to take a connection from there, and connect that into like that. So this time, so we've still got the permanent live run into all three PIRs. So at no point does the permanent live get disconnected. It's always, all three PIRs are permanently live. But this time we have a one-way switch. Again, it's still in parallel with these switches. And so if this switch was to be closed, like so, now you've got a circuit. You've got a circuit that's running through here, down through here, down through the switch, back up, back to the switch line, all the way back, and then through to the lights, and then the lights will come on. The reason I've drawn it here, the reason I've done the connections in here, is because there's not always a lot of space at the back of a PIR to add any further connections. It can get quite cramped in there. So here, we could actually use you might install something like a junction box in there to do the connection for that one, because there's not a lot of space in the back of the PIR. But that's how you operate a manual override switch in this scenario.